Shout out to the elect, giving all praise and glory to Yahweh Shemuel Shai, Shemuel Kakadash, and giving double honors to the other apostles, the other bishops, the great millstone. Well, peace and salutations to the elect. Alright, so Shemuel Moffin is a Mafla from the great millstone playing tables camp. Katie here in the city of Philadelphia just coming with a wee lesson in the spirit. I thought this was Philadelphia for a second, but it's actually it's New York. And you see what you see, the flags and Ephraimites. These are so-called Puerto Rican flags. And you got the Ephraimites. Ephraim is the so-called Puerto Ricans. They're Hebrew Israelites. It's one of the 12 tribes. All right, and actually is the head tribe on the northern kingdom, all right, side. Okay, you have the, the split with the southern, which would be Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, which would be your so-called Negroes, West Indians, and Judah being the so-called Negroes. Benjamin is so-called West Indians, and Levi is so-called Haitians. Giving you their biblical nationality for their tribe. And you have Ephraim would be on the Northern Kingdom side. even though we're one nation, when you have it, Ephraim is the so-called Puerto Ricans. All right. And you see, these are Israelites. Look how you know, flashy Jake is, and Ephraim is, look, they in all parts of government. You know, Ephraim is reflected as police, you know, sergeants, and you know, different ranks within government. various different positions. City council, you know, various state representatives, and you know, senators, all of that, you know, and Israelites, you know, we are, as the, as they say, the, it's written as this, the sand of the sea. Okay, give me one moment. I'm gonna draft some precepts. I'm just gonna still lead this up. Fair use worn out only this footage. This is from the NYC Walking Shell. This is for educational purposes only. Like right here, you have a darker skinned Ephraimite right here. Woman right there. Let me see. That dude got like dreadlocks going off, but some got beards. You know, but this is Ephraim. Ephraim is huge. You know, this, you know, look, they even got the, you know, this old pride flag thing going on. Look, you got, there you go, dark-skinned Ephraimites right there, dark-skinned Ephraimites right there, dark-skinned Ephraimite right there. Okay? Look, got the will. So I'm gonna pause it. Yes, in the spirit, and we'll just get a couple scriptures, because Ephraim, so this is the book of Hosea chapter 7 and 8. Says Ephraim, which is so-called Puerto Ricans, he hath mixed himself among the people. Ephraim is a cake not turnt. Okay, again, with a cake being, you put a pancake on a grill, on a griddle, you have the top bit, you know, being lighter in hue, And then obviously the bit before, when you flip it upside down, you have it darker. And that's how the Ephraimites are. Okay, you have darker and lighter hue Ephraimites. And, you know, I can say I'm an Ephraimite myself. And it goes back when you go into Ephraim. When you break down the name Ephraim, it's in the Hebrew, Aparyam. Okay? A-pa-ra-ya-ma. Which all together, Aparyam, which ah means I. And Parium, go back to going to when you chase it, go back to par, par, really the root para or paria or yeah, going back to being to bear fruit or fruitful. So I am fruitful. Okay, that's Ephraim, which is going into the so-called Puerto Ricans. Second son of Yahweh Sapa, Joseph, blessed by him, given preference over his first son, Manasseh. All right. And these are your so-called Puerto Ricans of today. All right. Now, you have it. There's other prophecies that you can go into. But it's a lot of Ephraimites there in New York. And here on the East Coast, you know, Philadelphia, going about Florida, you know, et cetera, and in America in general. All right. This is Hosea 7:11. It says, Ephraim also is like a silly dove without heart. They call to Egypt. They go into Assyria. Okay. America. All right. And yeah, we had the Ephraimites, you know, they're here. Ephraimites are real dumb too. A lot of times too. I can say go back to silly. Pathah, go back to open. Alright, being easily basically open minded to be incised and also being deceived. You know, and look at like you see with these Ephraimites. You know, Ephraimites into all different type of religions, especially with the Catholicism, that were they into all types of doctrines of life, and madness. One thing about Ephraim, you know, Ephraim loved cars too. You know, look at that. Ephraim got Lambos. This Lambo looks so clean right there, with a wrap on it. You know. You know, got different Corvettes and all that. You know, Ephraim is real, real flashy and silly and like making jokes and stuff like that. You know, too. We're real lively. All right. But look at all these Ephraimites. This is crazy. Okay. Stunting out a whole, some type of super duty truck, tow truck type deal. Now this is Israel, man. You know, these are Israelites. They don't Israel heathens don't be like this, okay? With all this spirit, okay? You know, and it's gonna be beautiful seeing our people when they all are in their proper fashion follow the law, statutes, commandments, and all righteous. Okay, because that's what, you know, we looking forward to. When the kingdom come, you know, the two-thirds are reborn in the kingdom, they're going to be all righteous. Okay? And we're going to be as how we are supposed to be, regal. All right? And, yeah, like, you can see, look at all these Ephraimites, like, it's crazy. Like, I've seen different parades. But look at how many of these. You can't tell me these are not Ephraim. Ephraim is usually they real procreate and get real fruitful. Okay, look at that, daughters. All right. Yeah, this is just like, it's like abundance of Ephraimites. This is just crazy. You know, and this, you know, you had it with the so-called Puerto Ricans. The rest of the northern tribes came over here to the Americas. All right. And you had different conquistadors that came and, you know, conquered us. All right. But we're not completely destroyed. Thankfully, the Lord left a remnant. Look how that one was as dark as me. You know? So let me get a couple other scriptures in the spirit. This is something I just seen. Yeah, this is the book of Genesis. Chapter 9. And 1 it says, "And Elohim blessed Noah and his sons and said unto them, Be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth." All right? And you have, obviously, out of Noah's three sons, you have whom we came out of, which we came out of Shem. Okay? This is Genesis chapter 9 and 18. "And the sons of Noah that went forth of the ark were Shem, Ham, and Japheth. And Ham is the father of Canaan." All right, you have it, Shem, which is Shem in the Hebrew, which means name. Okay, that's one of our forefathers. You have Japheth, it'll be like your Pacific Islanders, you know, Hawaiians, different Polynesians and such. You got Ham, so-called Africans. All right, you got Shem, which, you can go on to Shem, the different descendants. Now Esau even came out of Shem, but he's not a chosen. Okay? But, you know, you have it, or you have a great fulfilling of being fruitful and multiplying. And you can see that with the Ephraimites, or Shemites, okay, as well. Okay? This is a good precept to go with another precept where they talk about Abraham. "And Elohim said unto him, I am the power almighty, be fruitful and multiply. A nation and a company of nations shall be of thee, and kings shall come out of thy loins, and the land which I gave Abraham and Isaac, to thee I will give it, and to thy seed after thee will I give the land." All right, Jacob is named in Israel. Okay, because you know you have it, a lot of people want to you don't know. Certain blessings is dealing with just Israel. All right. They just don't understand the precepts. Okay. Genesis chapter 17:5. You can read the whole thing on your own. All right. Neither shall thy name be called more Abram, but thy name shall be called Abraham. All right, which you have it. Abraham going to Abraham, which going to a father of a multitude. All right. You got Abram, my exalted father, Abraham. All right. Going on. And I will make thee exceedingly fruitful, and I will make nations of thee, and kings shall come out of thy loins. And kings shall come out of thee, and I will establish my covenant between me and thee, and thy seed after thee in their generations for everlasting covenant, to be a power unto thee, to thy seed after thee. Okay. And then you have a covenant also with circumcision, which was not given to all nations. All right. And you have it with a lot of our people. They have a zeal and follow some of these different various laws. Because we were given these different laws. You have some of our people that may not follow it because they forgot their heritage. Okay. Because over here, you just go into some history. You know, we came over here, as they say. It said in 2nd Edges, 13th chapter, leaving Assyrian captivity to come over here to the New World. You know, we were to follow our own laws, but then we started going into idolatry. All right, and the heathen, came over, and went and conquered us with conquistadors and stuff. All right, this is book of 2nd Edges chapter 13:40. Those are the 10 tribes, okay, which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king, who Shalmaneser the king of Assyria led away captive, and he carried them over the waters, and they came into another land. But they took this counsel among themselves, that they would leave the multitude of the heathen and go into the further country, where never mankind dwelt, that's here in Americas, that they might there keep their statutes, which they never kept in their own land. Okay? And they entered into the Euphrates by narrow places of the river, where the Most High then showed signs for them and held still the flood till they were passed over. For though through that country there was a great way to go, namely of a year and a half, in the same region is called Ashereth. All right, going to another land. Okay. It's just dealing with here in the Americas. All right, so you have it. How did so-called Puerto Ricans get over here? Different other northern tribes, Cubans, different Mexicans, El Salvador, or Zebulonites, Panama, to get the 12 tribes. All right. 12 tribes of Israel chart, which you have your northern kingdom is Ephraim, Manasseh, Gad, Reuben, Naphtali, Asher, Issachar, which Issachar is the Mexicans. Asher is Colombia to Uruguay. You have it, the Argentinians to Chileans is the Naphtali. Reuben, so-called Seminole Indians. Gad is North American Indians. Manasseh, Cubans, and the Puerto Ricans are the Ephraimites. All right, and these are your northern tribe kingdoms that came over here. Northern tribe Israelites that came over here from out of Assyrian captivity under Shalmaneser the Third of Assyria. I believe this is Shalmaneser the Third. We'll go into it more deeper in another lesson. And you know that Ephraimites are Israelites because they found Hebrew relics in Puerto Rico. Okay. And you can look at those different artifacts on your own, okay? Just like you have with Native Americans as well, all right? Artifacts in Puerto Rico written in Hebrew. You know, it was in Assyrian captivity. Where would they learn Assyrian to write it down as what he called modern Hebrew? Okay. Check this out real quick. Right there. 800 ancient stones with Hebrew writing in Puerto Rico, authenticated. Okay, and I'm pretty sure I probably got a lesson up there somewhere with it too. Okay, so yeah, man, you know, just going real brief into some things. You know, the Ephraimites, you know, House of Joseph, mainly Ephraim. Okay. Numbers 1 and 32 of the children of Joseph, namely the children of Ephraim by their generations, after their families by the house of their fathers, according to the number of the names from 20 year old and upward, all that were able to go forth to war. Okay, so I'm just showing some heritage, some true, because you're not rich ports, conquistador call you a rich port, come pillaging gold out of the Ephraimites. Okay, but we're Ephraimites, we're fruitful. So just wanted to cover that. One of the tribes, 12 tribes of Israel, being Ephraim, that's in brief. They got a Puerto Rican day parade. You know, look. Remember, our women are lively. That's part of being a Israelite, is being lively. Okay? our women are lively. You can read that also in the scriptures too. Okay. These are not heathen, meaning other nations, even though they are acting as heathen. These are Israelites. Okay. These are Israelites. I mean, you have heathen that's gonna be in there that look like Israelite, look like what we call so-called Puerto Rican, too. Look, she got an afro, kinda. But these are Ephraimites, all right. She could be an Ephraimite even though looking like an E because remember, conquistadors looked at the women, seen they were beautiful, and wanted to lay down. So you know, hey. They look, some of them look like so-called white people, but actually are Ephraimites, okay? So, you know, the history is deep and vast. You know, going to the Taino Indians and all of that, the good people, all right? Borican and all that. But, yeah. So, that's it. Through the Spirit, shalom to the elect.